Hare Krishna. The mind overvalues things it doesn't have and undervalues things it does have. Suppose we are buying or selling something. Say, if we are in a barter market where we have to sell certain things and we have to exchange certain things for certain things. So now we have certain products. Normally, we would want to get the best price for them. So we would need to know what is the value of those things. And then if we have to barter them, then if somebody has something else, we need to know its rights value, rights right value. And then we can have the proper barter. So similarly, for us, if we consider our mind, we are always exchanging things. So for example, we may be, for example, trying to focus on Krishna, think of Krishna, and we have the resources, the facilities by which we can focus on Krishna. And there are myriad sense objects and temptations available outside. So the mind tends to undervalue what we have. Oh, this Krishna consciousness, I can do it anytime. What's the big deal about it? And oh, this particular cricket match score, oh, this political news, oh, this particular Facebook update, it's something which I will not have. I want it right away. Now, actually speaking, those things, they may not be at all important. But the mind tends to overvalue what it does not have. Oh, what is the latest update? What is this? Oh, and it undervalues what we do have. And this applies not just with respect to spiritual and material things, but also with respect to everything. The people who are already reciprocating nicely with us, we tend to undervalue them. And the people who don't give us the time of the day, we crave for a little of their attention. So like that, we lose out. We don't use the things that we have. We don't relish the things that we have because we don't value them. The Bhagavad-Gita urges us to practice discipline of the mind. What does discipline of the mind mean? It means that we recognize that our mind is tricky and we consciously cultivate satisfaction by dwelling on the things that we have rather than on the things we don't have. 17:16 in the Bhagavad-Gita states, Manah prasad saumyatvam maunam atma vinigraha bhavasam shuddhirityetat tapomanasam ucchate. Tapomanasam. Discipline of the mind is Manah prasada. Cultivate satisfaction of the mind. So when we consciously remind ourselves using our intelligence, using our experience, using our study of scripture to value things properly, then we will know what things to trade for how much value. So while we are doing important things, if something else comes up, whether we should stop that important thing to do something else, we'll be able to evaluate it properly. We won't get distracted. And we will, by focusing on the things that are truly important for us, get deep inner enrichment. Thank you. Hare Krishna.